Hi guys, this is Shivansh Goyal from Lexus and Company, and today I am going to discuss about divorce under Hindu law. So divorce is basically resolution of a marriage. Divorce can either be taken through mutual consent or under section 13 clause 1. There are some of the grounds mentioned under which party can seek divorce. First of all, there are three theories which are defined under divorce. First is fault theory, here under this theory it is completely defined when one party is liable for that mistake. If a party commits fraud or forgery, then under that case divorce can be taken. Second is mutual consent. Here divorce is basically taken by mutual consent of both the parties. Here no force or no threat should be used, and if it is used, then under that case divorce will not be held liable under law. And third is retrievable breakdown, where one party is not able to live with another party in one roof, and also the court does not have any power to grant divorce within 1 year. Here the court basically gives power to both the parties to settle their disputes within a period of 1 year, and if they are not able to do that, then under that case a petition of divorce can be filed. So now let's discuss about the grounds of divorce, which are basically defined under section 13 clause 1. First is adultery. If a husband or a wife have found that they are having intercourse with another man or a woman in the bed, then under that case divorce can be filed either by husband or by wife. So it's a main essential would be when husband or the wife is having intercourse with another man or woman without her consent. Okay, and then comes cruelty. It can be either physically or through mentally. If the husband tortures her wife or he imposes false allegations on her or his family or his friends tortures her, then under that case cruelty can be filed under the family court. And if continuously harassment is being given to her, or if husband is demanding continuously dowry from wife, then under that case petition of divorce can be filed. Then comes leprosy, in which either husband or the wife is suffering from that kind of disease, and due to which he or she can't be cured, then under that case divorce can be taken. Then comes if after the marriage if wife or husband came to know that they are of unsound mind, then under that case petition of divorce can be filed. And then the last thing is, when either husband or wife decides that they will go to the path of God, then under that case petition of divorce can be filed. And the last one is, if either husband or the wife is missing for the span of 7 years or above, then under that case petition of divorce can be filed. So I hope that you have understood divorce under Hindu law in a short form.